A very good afternoon, everyone. Very good afternoon, guys. How are you all? कैसे आप सब लोग? Very good afternoon. Welcome, guys. कैसे आप सब लोग? जल्दी से फटाफट कमेंट करके बताइए, क्विकली टेल मी एवरीवन। गुड आफ्टरनून गाइस, सो टुडे इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेशन। ओके, सो इन द टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कसिंग अ फ्यू न्यूमेरिकल्स based upon design of concrete structures and specifically design of beams. Okay, so we are going to be seeing some numericals in general. Good afternoon, Bharat. Welcome, guys. Welcome. Quick, join fast, guys. We'll wait for another 1 or 2 minutes and then we are going to start the session. So in this session, today's session, I'm going to be discussing some multiple select type questions. Multiple select type questions, MSQ questions. So you are going to be having more than one options to be correct in these type of questions. Okay, so these type of questions are you going to be asked in the GATE 2021 examination this year, right? So you are left with only very few days, hardly a week is left to your GATE examination, right? So this is a very high time to go through the concepts which are asked very frequently, very repeatedly. Okay, welcome, welcome, guys. How's the Josh, guys, to the GATE examination? You are going for the GATE examination. Some of you might be going for it, the GATE examination for the first time. Some of you might have attempted it before also. How is the Josh, guys? How are you feeling right now? Tell me, everyone. So now your hard work throughout the year which you have paid, okay, now it is going to be tested. The final exam is coming, guys. For the examination, okay, do not get tensed in the examination, okay. Stay easy, stay calm if you have done your hard work throughout the year, okay. No one can take the fruit which you are going to bear out of your hard work, okay? Do not spoil that by yourself, okay? Do not spoil it by yourself. You have done your hard work, you are definitely going to do well in the examination, okay? So firstly, I would like to welcome you all to the India's greatest live learning platform, that is GradeUp. So my name is Rohan Goyal and I have scored an All India rank of 96 in GATE 2020, and prior to that I have scored an All India rank of 366 in GATE 2016. I have a master's degree in structural engineering from IIT Bangalore, and these are the subjects that I teach at GradeUp. So let us start with some numericals which are very important for the GATE point of view and are expected, such type of questions are expected in the GATE 2021 examination. So these numericals are specifically framed by me to have an idea, to tell you, give you an idea what type of questions can we expect from the concrete structures if it is asked in a multiple select type questions. So first MSQ type question, you can see it on your screen. An M25 grade of concrete, which of the following statements is or are correct? Tell me, guys, which of the following statements is or are correct for an M25 grade concrete? Tell me, everyone. Pay attention to each and every point carefully, okay? Do not be in a hurry to answer the question. You have good 2 minutes to solve the question in the GATE examination, okay? You have good amount of time to solve the question. And in hurry, if you will be in a hurry to solve each and every question, you are going to definitely going to make some silly mistakes, which is going to cost you some negative marking. Okay, so do not let even a single marks be deducted from your marks which you deserve. Okay, so take your time. Okay, you have good amount of time to go through each and every question. Take your time, read the question twice, read the units in which the data is given to you. Okay, read the parameters which are given to you. Read properly what is asked from the question. What are you asked to calculate from the questions? And in what unit are you asked to provide the question, answer to the question? So read all these things carefully before answering the question. Okay. Read twice, and when you are typing the answer or when you are clicking the answer, read again whether you are providing the answer to that same value which is asked in the question. Okay. You have to pay attention over there. Tell me, guys, what is the answer to this question, guys? What is the answer to this question? Yes, Bharat, what is the answer to the question, guys? Tell me, Bharat. More than one options are going to be correct in this question. Tell me. More than one option is correct in this question, guys. No idea. Shall I continue? Shall I tell you the answer? A, C, and D. A, C, and D. Okay. Let us find the answer. Let us go through the answers. Okay. So the first option is obviously correct because the characteristic strength of concrete is obviously 25 megapascal for M25 grade concrete. It is obviously correct. So A option is definitely there. B option says that 95% of the test results are expected to fail at compressive strength greater than 25 megapascal. Bharat, this option is also correct. This option is also correct because, see, if we call a concrete as M25 concrete, so it means that 5% of cases you will get a strength of less than 25 megapascal. And this is what is defined in the IS 456-2000. This is what is defined in the IS 456-2000. Pay attention, everyone. Pay attention. In IS 456-2000, the characteristic strength is defined as the strength below which not more than 5% of the test results are expected to fail. So 5% of the test results will have a strength less than 25 megapascal. That means remaining 95% of the test results will have a strength greater than 25 megapascal. And this is what I have written in the B statement. Tell me, is the statement right or wrong? Tell me, Bharat. Everyone, is the statement right or wrong? What do you think now? After analyzing this statement carefully, what do you think is the answer? Any change in the answer? Any change in the answer? Any change in the answer? Okay. Now, A option is also correct. B option is also correct. C option is modulus of rupture. Modulus of rupture is FCR, which is equal to 0.7 under root FCK. This we already know. So, substituting the value of characteristic strength, we will get 0.7 into under root of 25, which will come out to be equal to 0.7 multiplied by 5, which is equal to 3.5 Newton per mm square. So that means the C option is also correct. C option is also correct. Now the D option, coming to the D option. So as per you, the D option is also correct. Now let us read the statement first. So pay attention to each and every word which is given in this statement. As per IS 456-2000, long-term static modulus of elasticity is equal to 25,000 megapascal. So long term static modulus of elasticity is given as the short term static modulus of elasticity divided by 1 plus creep coefficient. And the short term static modulus of elasticity is 5000 under root FCK. So this is your long term and this is your short term. In long term, we take into consideration the effect of creep also. Okay. So the short term will be equal to 5000 into under root of 25, which will come out to be equal to 25 into 10 to the power of 3 mega Pascal. So the value which is given over here is not for long term static modulus of elasticity. Instead, it is for short term static modulus of elasticity. Long term will take into consideration the effect of creep. So the D statement is not correct. It is incorrect statement. So the answer to this question is A, B, C. Any doubts to anyone? Tell me, guys. Any doubts to anyone in this question? Tell me, everyone. Is your doubt clarified? Any doubt remaining? Anything you would like to ask from this question? A very good question, guys. A very good question. In the GATE examination, you have to read the question twice. You have to pay attention to each and every word that is given in the question. In the question, a single word will be changed and the answer is going to change drastically. Your question is going to become incorrect instead of being correct. You have to read the statement twice at least. Now pay attention. Now read the statement in the next question. Okay. Read the statement in the next question. Easy question. Easy question. So try to solve this question, everyone. Read the question. This is a multiple select type question. This is a multiple select type question. So you have more than one options to be correct in this question. Now let us find out how many of you are able to give me the right answer. So over here, instead of compression, it is tension. This is tension. Now give me the answer, everyone. Tell me the answer. A very basic question, very easy question. This type of questions is probable to be asked in the GATE examination. Such an easy question can also be asked, and a good tough question can also be asked, which is very conceptual, requires a thorough reading of the question. Tell me, guys, what is your answer? What is your answer, guys? Tell me. Avinash, read the question again and check whether your answer is right or wrong. Read the question again. Wrong answer, Avinash Bhagat, wrong answer. I want you to read the question again. I want you to look at the question once again. Let us go through the question, let us read the question and let us understand the question. What does the question say? What does the question say? For a design of a reinforced concrete member, for the design of reinforced concrete members in flexure, which of the following cases are considered for safe design of an RCC member in flexure? Which of the following cases are considered for a safe design. Whenever design, whenever you design a flexural member, what type of design do you prefer for a safe design? Options are over-reinforced section, tension failure, compression failure, under-reinforced section. So what type of design do you prefer? What is the safe design? What type of design do you prefer for a flexural member? So whenever we design a member, for a safe design, we want the reinforcement shall fail under tension and the concrete shall not fail under compression, because the failure of concrete is a sudden failure due to which we do not get any indication prior to the actual failure. So we do not want a compression failure, we want a tension failure, which is due to the failure of the reinforced steel. And because the steel is a ductile member, we get sufficient amount of deformation before the actual failure, and due to which we get an indication in terms of deformation that the section is about to fail, and we get some prior time to vacate the building, to vacate the area, so that we can go back to go to a safer location before the structure actually fails. So we are getting some indication before the actual failure, and hence we recommend, and hence we always want to design a tension failure. We always want to design a section which is having tension failure, not compression failure. We do not want a compression failure, because compression failure is a sudden failure. It is a sudden failure. Okay? It is a sudden failure. Now, whether to design an over-reinforced section or an under-reinforced section. Now, if a section is an over-reinforced section, we are providing greater amount of steel reinforcement. That is why it is referred to as over-reinforced section. And if the reinforcement area is more, that means your steel will not fail, your concrete will fail, which is a compression failure, which is a sudden failure, which is not recommended. So we do not want to design an over-reinforced section. Instead, we want to design an under-reinforced section, in which the failure is due to the failure of steel bars, due to the deformation in the steel bars, due to the yielding of the steel bars, which is a ductile failure. And hence, the answer to this question is B and D. B and D. Any doubts? Any doubts to anyone? So guys, at the end of the session, stay tuned. At the end of the session, I'm going to give you some homework question also, some MSQ questions which you can solve. And those questions, I'm going to see how many of you are interested to actually get a very good rank in the GATE examination and want to score excellent marks in the GATE examination. I want you guys to take a screenshot of those questions and tell me the answers to those questions by sending it to my email address. I will provide you my email address. Over there, you will have to send those answers to the questions to my email address. Okay? That is why, Abhinash, I say that read the question twice at least. Twice. Very, very, very important. You have sufficient amount of time in the GATE examination. You have more than 2.5 minutes to solve each and every question. Okay, that is a very sufficient amount of time. In those, see, per question, you have more than 2.5 minutes, right? And there are some one marks question also, which do not require even 1 minute also, which required hardly 30 to 40 seconds. So you have, on an average, you can say that you have more than 3 minutes to read each and every question, to solve each and every question. Excluding the one marks question, if we exclude some of the one marks question, which do not require any time at all, you have sufficient amount of time to solve each and every question in the GATE examination. So read each and every question twice. Very, 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 very important. Write it down somewhere which you, where you can see every day before the GATE examination. To read each and every question twice in the GATE examination. Clear? Do not solve it in a hurry. Do not be in a hurry to solve the questions in the GATE examination. Okay? Moving on to the next question. A very good question indeed. Very good question. Okay, this is a very good question, and this question, if it is asked in a GATE examination, many students, I am saying 90 to 95% students will not be able to solve this question. I can guarantee it. Design strength of M25 concrete is or are in limit state method. In limit state method. In limit state method. What is the design strength of M25 concrete in limit state method? So you have four options: in direct compression and in bending compression. Direct compression, bending compression. Tell me what are the values. Tell me what are the values in limit state method. Think and answer. Do not answer me in a hurry. Take your time, give some thought to the question, and then answer. And even if you are not sure in any of the two options, in any of the two options, you can comment in the chat section between like B and C. Sorry. Suppose you are confused between A and C option, but you are sure that B is the right answer. So you can write B comma A slash C. So that means you are confused between these two options. Okay, you are sure about the B option, but you are confused between A and C option. You can also comment in that manner also. Okay, so by that I will know where are you actually having a doubt, and I can focus on that point and I can clarify your doubt at that point itself. Is it clear to all? Bhagat, Abhinash, Aniket, Yogesh. Is it clear to all? Tell me the answer, guys. Tell me the answer, everyone. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Very easy question, does not require much time to solve the question, but if the concepts are clear, it is a question which could be solved within a minute. Unable to solve, no problem, no problem. So first of all, tell me, what is the flexural strength of concrete under bending compression? Can anyone tell me what is the flexural strength of concrete in bending compression in limit state method? In limit state method. Flexural strength of concrete under bending compression in a limit state method. Who can tell me what is the flexural strength of concrete under bending compression in limit state method? What is the maximum stress value that you take when you are designing for the beams? So, in limit state method, your bending compression under bending compression, your strength is equal to 0.45 FCK, and under direct compression, your strength is 0.40 FCK. And in limit state, in working stress method, it is equal to sigma CBC, and this is equal to sigma CC, which is almost equal to FCK by 3 and almost equal to FCK by 4. Although a table is given in the IS 456-2000, but an approximate value can also be calculated using this formula. Since we are asked to find out In limit state method, your bending compression is going to be equal to 0.45 into 25, which will come out to be equal to, what is the value you are getting? I guess you will get the value as 11.25 megapascal. And under the direct compression, you will get 0.40 into 25, which will be equal to 10 megapascal, right? And in limit, in working stress method, sigma CBC is equal to, for M25 grade concrete, it is equal to 8.5 megapascal, okay? And sigma CC is equal to 6.0 megapascal. So these values over here are given for working stress method, and these values over here are given for limit state method. So the answer to this question is A and B. Is it clear to all? Is it clear to all? I hope the stresses in both limit state method and working stress method is now crystal clear to all of you. If such type of question is asked, you are easily be able to answer the question based upon this numerical. Am I right or wrong? Tell me, everyone. Am I right or wrong? Click on the like button and tell me, everyone. Click on the like button and tell me, everyone. Is this question crystal clear to all? Thank you, Bharat. Thank you so much. And guys, I will be taking some marathon classes also. Okay, I will be taking around 2 to 3 hour classes in which I'm going to be discussing numericals from geotechnical engineering, steel design, design of concrete structure for the GATE 2021 examination. And we are going to be discussing all the important type of numericals over there. Okay, I'm going to start it on 1st of February, and I'm going to notify you over the app on the YouTube also. I'm going to post a introductory video to all of you. Okay. Now continuing to the next question. Okay. So do attend those marathon series. Okay. Those are very important. Which of the following load combinations is or considered for the IAS recommended by the IAS 456-2000 for the limit state of serviceability? Pay attention. For the limit state of serviceability. How many of you remember the load combinations that you might have studied in the design of concrete structures? How many of you remember it? Very important. Very, very important. Load combinations are very, very important. A lot of questions are asked in the previous year and are expected to be asked in the upcoming examination. Of such type of multiple select type question could be easily asked. A very easy 1 marks question can be asked on this, or this type of question. 1 marks question can be asked in the GATE examination. Very easy question, very scoring question. If you know the load combinations, you can easily answer the question and come. Score 1 mark easily. Tell me, everyone. Tell me the answer. Meanwhile, I'm going to draw a table for you guys. Yes, what is the answer, guys? Okay, I think the question is not visible, right? Tell me, everyone. I want each and everyone to answer. If you do not remember the load combinations for the different limit state of serviceability and limit state of collapse, now you can look it over here. Now you can pay attention now. Okay, if you haven't studied, you can pay attention right now. Okay. So for any section, when we are designing the section for different limit state of collapse, for example, when we are designing the section for flexural failure or compression failure or torsional failure or tension failure, okay, whenever we are designing a section, we check the section for limit state of collapse. What does it mean? We take different load combinations into consideration, and based upon those different load combinations, which of the load combination gives us the highest value, the load combination which gives us the highest value, we will take that load combination into consideration and we'll design the section for that load combination. Now, different partial factor of safety values are recommended by the IS code for the different load combinations, which I'm going to give you now. Okay. And once the section is designed, the section is checked for limit state of serviceability, which is, what is limit state of serviceability? Serviceability is how the structure is going to perform during its service time. That means how much deflection it is going to get, how much vibration it is going to have, how much corrosion it is going to take place, okay, and how much cracks are going to develop. All these are limit state of serviceability, and which are checked for the working loads. So the partial factor of safety is given according to that. So over here we are asked for the limit state of serviceability. So first of all, let us find out what are the three load combinations. The load combinations are, first one is dead load plus live load. Second one is dead load plus wind load or earthquake load. We take either wind load or earthquake load. We never consider wind load and earthquake load simultaneously, because the probability of occurrence of wind load and the earthquake load simultaneously is very less. So we never consider wind load and earthquake load simultaneously. We either consider wind load or we consider earthquake load. If there is any doubt at any point, you can ask. Third one is, third load combination is dead load plus live load plus wind load or earthquake load. So these are your three load combinations: dead load plus live load, dead load plus wind load or earthquake load, dead load plus live load plus wind load or earthquake load. These are your three load combinations. Now the partial factor of safety for the limit state of collapse is, so for dead load plus live load, 1.5, and since there is no wind load and earthquake load, 1.5, nothing, 1.5. And this is 1.2, 1.2 and 1.2. And in one special case, we take value of 0.9 also in this load combination. Okay, in this load combination, because this 0.9 value is considered when the overturning of the section is critical. Okay. Clear? Okay. Now, these are your limit state of collapse partial factor of safeties. Now for limit state of serviceability, these values are 1.0, 1.0, 1.0, 1.0, 1.0, 0.8 and 0.8. So according to this, what are the load combinations? For the different type of limit state of collapse and limit state of serviceability. So first one, first load combination, 1.5 times dead load plus live load. This is for limit state of collapse, not limit state of serviceability. So A is incorrect option. B option, 0.9 dead load plus 1.5 wind load, which is also a limit state of collapse load combination. Dead load plus live load, which is a limit state of serviceability load combination. Dead load plus 0.8 live load plus 0.8 earthquake load is also a limit state of serviceability load combination. So the answer to this question is C and D, guys. Clear? Is it clear to all? Any doubts? If this question is crystal clear to all, if the load combinations are crystal clear to all, send a thumbs up button in the comment section, everyone. If the load combinations are crystal clear to all, send a thumbs up button in the comment section, everyone. Abhinash, if in the previous question the design stresses values under tension is asked, it is equal to modulus of rupture, your 0.7 under root FCK, that is your value for tension. Okay, any doubts up till now? Any doubts to anyone? Clear to all? Is it clear to all? Okay. Moving on to the next question. Very important question. Okay. And an easy question also. A very easy question also and an important question also. A M35 grade concrete block is subjected to an initial loading off at an age of 28 days after casting. So that means the concrete block is subjected to an initial loading after 28 days of casting. Which of the following statement is or are correct? Tell me, everyone. Tell me, guys. A very good question. A very good question. Let me see how many of you are able to answer to this question, guys. Very good question. So the concept has already been told you to you in the first question itself. In the first question itself, I have told you the concept to how to solve this question. If you have paid attention over there, you will definitely be able to solve this question, guys. If you like these questions, tomorrow we are going to discuss some more questions. I have a lot of questions that I have kept in line to be discussed. So tomorrow we are going to discuss some more questions based upon this. Okay, tomorrow you can come at the same time at 1 p.m. We are going to be discussing such type of very good multiple select type questions. Okay, which are expected in the GATE examination, which are framed by me exclusively for you guys. Okay, and we are going to have a lot of fun concepts tomorrow. Okay, I'm also going to give you some homework questions also, which you can solve after the session is done. You can send those answers to the questions to me on my email ID, which I'm going to provide you guys shortly. Okay, if there is any other doubt regarding your preparation, regarding anything you would like to ask me, you can ask me over there. Okay, I'm always available for you guys, always ready to help you out in whatever way it is possible. Okay, wherever you need my help. Okay, if you are not able to concentrate, if you are not if you are feeling down due to the examination, whatever it may be, you can comment me, you can tell me on my email address, you can send me your issue, and I will definitely reply back to you. Okay. Yes, definitely we are going to have, I have planned three sessions. Okay, today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow. I have three sessions in which I'm going to be discussing such type of very good questions. I have a lot of questions. If I will show you, see these many questions I have lined up. All these questions are going to be discussed in these three series. All these questions are going to be discussed in these three series. And a very good questions, guys. Yes, I will definitely provide email ID, Bhagat. I will provide you my email ID shortly, okay? Stay tuned. I will provide you my email ID once I give you the homework questions. Okay. Next question is my homework question only. Okay. We are going to wind up the today's session shortly, and I'm going to give you some homework questions. Along with that, I will provide you my email ID also. You can ask me any doubt regarding your preparation over there. So over here, you are given M35 grade concrete and you are asked to tell me what are the following options are correct. And you are given that the age at which the concrete block is loaded, which is 28 days. Now the modulus of elasticity, which will come into which is asked in the question is long-term modulus of elasticity. You are asked to find out the long-term modulus of elasticity, which is equal to 5000 under root FCK divided by 1 plus theta, where theta is your creep coefficient, which takes into consideration the effect of creep, and which is equal to ultimate creep strain divided by elastic strain. Elastic strain. Now, this value of creep coefficient is given in the IS 456 as per IS 456 2000. As per IS 456 2000. This value of the creep coefficient depends upon the age of concrete at initial loading after casting. What is the age of concrete at initial loading after casting? Based upon that, the creep coefficient is, the recommended value of the creep coefficient values are given in the IS 456. So we have the creep coefficient values based upon if the concrete is loaded after 7 days, if the concrete is loaded after 28 days, if the concrete is loaded after 1 year. The value of the creep coefficient corresponding to these values is 2.2, 1.6 and 1.1. Remember these values over here itself. If such type of question is asked in the GATE examination, I want you guys to do the question. I do not want you guys to come back empty-handed. I want you guys to solve this question in the GATE examination if it is asked. Very easy question, straightforward question, and a lot of probability to be asked in the GATE examination. So based upon the question, that means our theta value is 1.6 for 28 days. Our theta value is 1.6 based upon 28 days. So that means your ultimate creep strain is equal to 1.6 times your elastic strain. So D option is correct. Your ultimate creep strain is equal to 1.6 times your elastic strain. And C option is incorrect. Okay. Now, let us find out the long-term modulus of elasticity, which is equal to 5000 under root of 35 divided by 1 plus 1.6, which is equal to, what is the value you are getting? What is the value you are getting, everyone? Tell me, guys. You will get the value as 11377 megapascal. So the right answer is B and D. The answer to this question is B and D is the right answer. Okay. Now, if there is any doubt, you can ask, guys. So the important topics for the structure analysis. For the structure analysis, you can revise at least those indeterminacy type questions. The stability of the questions, stability of the structures, okay, indeterminacy, stability, movement distribution method, okay, truss analysis is very, very important, trusses, okay, these four topics at least you can do completely, okay, these four topics you can revise properly, okay, you can solve the previous year questions based upon these topics at least, okay, clear? Now let us come back to the homework questions. So this is your first homework question. So you have to send me the answer to this question on my email address. Note down my email address. rohan.goyal@gradeup.co. So you have to send me the answer to this question on my email address, everyone. You have to send me the answer to this question on my email address over here. This is your first homework question. Okay. And this is your second homework question. This is your first homework question and this is your second homework question. And the next class, I'm going to tell all the, I'm going to take the names of all those students who have solved these two questions and who are going, who are doing very well, who are very sincere regarding their preparation. Okay. Meanwhile, I will introduce you guys to the courses which are offered at GridUp. So have you taken the screenshot? Sorry, 1 second. Let me give you the screenshot. Take the screenshot. Take this screenshot. Have you taken the screenshot? Click on the thumbs up button and tell me everyone. Comment the thumbs up button and tell me everyone if the screenshot is taken. The screenshot is taken or not? Most probably, Bharat, I will let you know by tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Okay. In this series only, I will let you know. I am having this class. I'm taking this series today, tomorrow and day after tomorrow. Today, we have already taken the class from 1 to 2. Tomorrow again, 1 to 2 and day after tomorrow also 1 to 2. I will let you know in the upcoming, in the two classes when I'm taking the marathon series. Okay. And those series are specifically going to be for GATE 2021 only. Okay. Most probably by tomorrow, I will let you know. Clear? Okay, I guess you have taken the screenshot. Now this next question, take the screenshot for this question also. Take the screenshot for this question also. Everyone. I hope the screenshot is taken. Okay. So, meanwhile, I will introduce you guys to the courses which are offered at GridUp. We have our GridUp course, GearUp course, which is your basic concept building course. If you want to build up your basic concepts, you can subscribe to this course. The next is your RankUp course. If you want to improve your GATE rank by the problem solving, you can subscribe to this course. The next is your Vision 2022 course. If you are aiming for GATE and DSE 2022, you can subscribe to this course. And if you subscribe to the GridUp Super, if you subscribe to GridUp Super, you get access to all the courses which are offered at GridUp. You get unlimited access to all the courses that are offered at GridUp, guys. Okay. And these are our star faculties who are going to be guiding you through your journey. And these are our past achievers. We have 60 plus GridUp students in top 100. With GridUp Super, you also get access to the GridUp Green Card also, with which you get additional benefits as listed over here. And for any doubts regarding the membership, you can contact on this given contact number. With GridUp Super, guys, you will get unlimited access to all the structured live courses and mock tests which are offered at GridUp. Thank you. That's all for the session, guys. Thank you. Goodbye. See you in the next session, guys. Bye, guys.